Appeals Court Judge Andy Bennett has spent a large portion of his life studying Tennessee's constitutions.
So I started getting into the constitution, state constitution, in law school when I took a course on state constitutions.
Bennett became a member of the Tennessee Attorney General's office before being appointed to the Court of Appeals in 2007.
I litigated a lot of state constitutional issues and I wrote opinions. And then on the Court of Appeals, I occasionally write opinions.
In Tennessee's 225 years of history, only three constitutions have been passed.
The first constitution was like all the other constitutions of the early states. And it had a weak governor and a very, very strong legislature.
The first constitution was written in 1796 when Tennessee delegates petitioned the federal government to become a state.
In January of 1796, five delegates from each county, 55 total, gathered in Knoxville to write a constitution. And it took them 27 days, which actually is a very short amount of time, but they did a lot of borrowing.
Before becoming a territory in 1789, Tennesseans lived under the umbrella of North Carolina.
They were already familiar and had lived under the Constitution of North Carolina that was written in 1776, and they borrowed a lot of that, and they borrowed a lot from the Pennsylvania Constitution of 1790. It was one of the more recent state constitutions and was viewed as modern.
Tennessee was the first territory to apply for statehood.
The Constitution was sent to Congress, and Congress debated on the admission of Tennessee until June 1st of 1796, when George Washington signed the act that made Tennessee a state.
The second constitution was drawn up nearly 40 years later.
Over time, the legislatures sort of gather the power that they can, and sometimes they go too far. And some people in Tennessee felt that in some things the legislature had too much power. So that was one of the reasons for having a constitutional convention in 1834.
The 1834 constitution included changes to the taxation provision by taxing land by value instead of acreage. That's also when the Tennessee Supreme Court was written into law to never be abolished.
The first constitution of Tennessee did not really set up a court system. It left all that to the legislature. So in 1830, the Tennessee Supreme Court issued several opinions that the legislature did not like, and there was a movement to abolish the Tennessee Supreme Court.
Then about 35 years later, another constitutional convention was called.
After the Civil War, we had a third constitutional convention in 1870. It was mostly a reaction to the Civil War and things that had happened in Reconstruction. For example, of course, it granted every male the right to vote. Females were still left out.
There hasn't been a full-blown convention since.
The 1870 Constitution is the one we still live under.
In fact, it stood unamended until 1953, which, according to the Tennessee State Library and Archives, is a world record. Bennett says there have been limited constitutional conventions in the past, but even that process has evolved.
After 77, the legislature has moved to the other method of amending the Constitution, which is legislative proposals. They propose an amendment. If a majority of the legislature likes it, approves it, it's published in a newspaper 6 months before the next election for the General Assembly so that people can talk about it with their representatives and all. And then the next General Assembly has to pass it by a two-thirds vote in each house, and then it goes to the people for a vote.
History buffs who want to review Tennessee's constitutions can do so by visiting the virtual Tennessee Archives online. Haley Wilgus, News 2.